Ah, all right. Can you hear me? Good. Now you have to hear this.
Does the world ever frighten you?
Sometimes.
Well, what do you do about that?
Well, I just close my eyes.
Raise your glasses. And then on my count, 1, 2, 3, 12. And L'chaim.
Those of us who came to the Negev dinner last year to honor Al Austin remember being warmly greeted at the door by the very gracious and dignified chair of the evening, Donna Reback. She was the very first person we saw the minute we entered the building, and she greeted us as if we were entering her own home. Donna made sure she devoted countless hours to the Negev dinner from beginning to end, and as a result, it was flawless. This singular captured moment was one of many that served as a blueprint for how Donna Ellen Reback approached all of her endeavors in life, whether it was family, her professions, philanthropy, community service, and her friendships. She was a woman for all seasons. Donna was born in July of 1938. She was the younger of two daughters to Ted and Betty Reback. She and her sister Faith were close in age and even shared some of the same friends and worked alongside one another for several community endeavors in the Jewish community and the entire city of Calgary. Donna looked after and expanded upon many of the initiatives that Ted Reback undertook. She followed in her father's footsteps. Speaking of Donna's father, actually both parents, a story about Camp B.B. Reback is most appropriate at this time because it sets the stage for who Donna is. In the rainy summer of 1953, Donna and Barb Jaffe, among other Calgary and Edmonton youth, were sitting out on picnic tables in the middle of a wet, soggy mess at a young Judea camp on Lake Chestermere. Now, for 2 weeks in the relentless rain, they had to endure outdoor plumbing and leaky cabins. Then when witnessed by Donna's parents when they came out to visit, Ted promptly said, ha, 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 this is no place for Jewish children. And that's how Camp B.B. Reback was born. With the enlistment of a dedicated committee from both cities, a new site for Calgary and Edmonton youth was sought after, found, and then built in a blink of an eye. Donna's father, Ted, well, he was just that kind of man. He'd just go and do it. And that's how Donna was raised, and that's how she lived. Donna was her father's girl, and if we were to lay bets, Donna's tutelage in commerce began at a very early age as seeds of her father's business acumen took firm root. Now talk about being ahead of her time. That was Donna, light years ahead, doing the unthinkable. Formal studies from Mills College in Oakland and graduate work from Stanford fortified her independent streak and also her passion for photography. Now here's a small sample of work, a photo of John F. Kennedy, no less. Yusuf Karsh could take a lesson or two from Donna. Before Donna trekked to New York, she began her professional career in San Francisco, going into schools, setting up youth groups for the Red Cross. Upon returning to Calgary from the glamorous life in New York, this maverick began teaching American history at Mount Royal College. She got married. She gave birth to her firstborn, Tevi, and only 2 years later, daughter Mia graced the family household, and Donna hit the ground running again, managing her household, being a doctor's wife, a supermom, and incorporating her love for theater by becoming one of the founders for Beth Israel Players, a Jewish musical theater company in Calgary. Donna, with her business savvy, started out as the producer of the company, literally doing everything from A to Z on a budget of zero, except actually directing the actors until she did in Funny Girl. In that musical, it wasn't enough for Donna to direct a play in Calgary. She had a mind to take the cast of thousands on tour, the whole kit and caboodle, not just to Vancouver, but to small town Alberta. You know, Donna was unstoppable. How she directed a play was no different from how she headed UJA, or she helped to shape the Lion of Judah in Calgary, or assisted in the Ways and Means Endowment at B'nai Tikva, or even helped to build that temple, or her invaluable involvement to facilitate the consolidation of the various Jewish community organizational funds under one umbrella into the Jewish Foundation of Calgary. Now, these are just only a few examples of some ventures she gave her heart and soul to. And as we speak of heart and soul, oh boy, Donna loved to laugh. She loved her music, and she loved her wine, and she loved her friends, but most of all, she loved her family. All of her children, Tevi, Mia, and Julie, and her grandchildren, Sophie and Gina, have precious memories that they will cherish forever. Tevi remembers his mom moving a skateboard ramp into the backyard with a huge crane and truck, one of the very few backyard ramps in Calgary at the time, for his buddies and him to master the sport. Now, what mom does that? She watched so many Flames and Stamp games with him that he lost count. And she never missed a Valentine's Day, a birthday, a Hanukkah, or any other special occasion. Never. Tevi remembers how painstakingly his mom instilled responsibility in him, in his sister Mia, and the whole family, and how driven she was to organize, plan, and execute any idea she believed in to the last detail. And don't we all know that? Planning for family trips for the last 8 years was to be remembered, especially the trip to New Orleans, which was so remarkable for Julie, Tevi's wife. Julie and Tevi both speak of the weekly Sunday dinners, and Julie especially. Well, she loved cooking with Donna, just being in her company for her guidance, her humor, her notes, her comics, for her love and her concern. And you know, Julie feels so proud to be called one of Donna's own, and calls Donna her own in return. And in Julie's words, "I aspire to be half the person that Donna was." Now for Mia, who, by the way, lovingly created this visual masterpiece to honor her mother, Donna was not only her mom, she was her best friend and confidant. They had wonderful traditions that were sacred to them alone, and they loved traveling together. Granddaughters Sophie and Gina, well, they have memories of reading Curious George, which was also Daddy's favorite, playing Rummy Cube and puppets and painting and drawing and going to the park with her Baba, eating Baba's delicious popcorn and going to Phil's for pancakes, as well as their 11th birthday that they celebrated with her in Jaffrey. Now, each one of Donna's friends, well, they thought they were her best friend because Donna's magic dust made them feel that way. Donna listened with her heart, gave 100% of her time, attention, and touch to everyone she knew and loved until she wasn't able to. And one of Donna's favorite expressions, near and dear to her heart, was "Mensch tracht, Gott lacht," which loosely translates to "people plan and God laughs." Now, Donna lived that expression authentically until her last moments with grace and grit. These few and many other precious, cherished memories from Donna's children and grandchildren will always remain. And you've also revisited just a few of the valued and significant gifts of tireless service, philanthropy, examples of guidance and hard work that Donna Reback has generously devoted to our community. And she's done so with grace and humility in quiet leadership. To honor her, perhaps we can learn from her tikkun olam, repairing the world, or construction for eternity, and pay it forward in her name. I ask you now to take a moment to reflect upon your own memories of Donna and smile. Listen to the music. Oh, that's Donna's music. And when you can't hear it anymore, I ask you to please quietly rise, raise your glass of wine as Donna much preferred wine. And on the count of three, I'll go one, two, three, we'll go to Donna. Listen to the music.
And thank you for the beautiful video tribute, Mia, that you put together for the family, and to Laura for narrating it so beautifully. At this point, we'd like to call up Mia and Tevi. If you could just come up, we've got a little presentation for you. We're really so grateful to you for sharing your mom with us at JNF and the rest of the Calgary community. She's such a huge contributor, and we really want to thank you. Ariella and Debbie and Sandra and I, on behalf of Calgary JNF, want to give you this little memento. Just to thank you so much for sharing your mom with us.
Wow, that was really incredible. Words cannot express our gratitude for this evening's tribute to our mother. She was a shining star, not only to our family, but to the Calgary Jewish community. Her love for the community was so evident in her lifelong desire to serve as a volunteer and her philanthropy to various agencies. It was part of her DNA to be involved, and she loved every minute of it, especially because she knew that through her hard work, others were being helped, whether here in Calgary or in Israel. One of her biggest joys was time spent with her family, especially with my daughter, Sophie and Gina, and she is dearly missed at all our family simchas. thank you to everyone who came tonight to support the Chasadna Music Conservatory. As you saw in the great tribute video put together by my sister Mia and Laura Schuer, who just nailed it, Mom loved music, loved Barbara, and loved Israel. Our family has had a long history with JNF, going back to my grandparents, Ted and Betty Reback, who were honored by the JNF Calgary back in 1966. I thank the Jewish National Fund for bestowing my mother with this tribute tonight. Many thanks to Sandra Fairman, Debbie Krieger, Cheryl Gervich, and the Gala Committee for the endless hours they gave to make this a most memorable evening. My wife Julie, who also was a huge help with this event, my sister Mia, my girls, and I are all very grateful for the warmth you have shown us. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everybody. I'd really like just to say, let's give another round of applause for Miss Laura Schuler for that wonderful, wonderful tribute. So this night is not over yet, but just a few reminders that we'd love to share with you tonight. The souvenir books on your tables as you came in, please do take home as well as the wildflower place cards. Sitting on your chairs as you came in was a gift bag from Maison Senior Living. They sponsored a wonderful parting gift along with the JNF blue boxes. Please fill those up, bring them back to the office. The girls at the office have a little bet going, and I bet the over about how many of them would come back. So if you could really please help and bring those back, we'll all be very happy. They're all gifts to you and to all of our honorees and our special guests who were asked to take home a centerpiece. Please feel free to take a centerpiece home. For everybody else, if you're taking home a centerpiece, please don't. You're just stealing. But that's it for me. That's it for me for the evening. It has been my pleasure. My official duties are done. It has been an honor being a part of this celebration, but I tell you that the party is just getting started. We're going to cap off this evening with a lot of more wonderful music. So one more time, I'm going to introduce to us Punchline and Stephanie Feldman. Thank you.